Welcome to Learn the Sky. We release new videos every Tuesday where we will be exploring the sky one constellation at a time. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and click the bell to get notifications about new videos. Learn the Sky is also on Patreon, so if you'd like to support this channel, visit the Patreon link listed below. And finally, if you would like to study the sky in greater detail and need a guide, visit learnthesky.com to learn about free lessons we offer and classes released each season. Welcome, my name is Janine, and in this video, we will learn about the star known as Albireo, which is represented as the head of the swan in the constellation of Cygnus. In this video, we're going to focus on one of the unique stars in the constellation of Cygnus the Swan. Cygnus can be a fairly easy constellation if you know the pattern and ways to find it. I will always encourage you to seek out dark skies when trying to find the constellations, but I recognize that may not always be a possibility. So here is the constellation pattern of Cygnus, and the brightest star in this pattern is called Deneb. It's part of the summer asterism triangle, and you use these three stars to help you find other constellations in the area. But even though Deneb is the brightest star in this constellation, there's another one that's really interesting to learn about, and this one is called Albireo. And in this video, we're going to explore some of the characteristics of Albireo and what it would look like if you would see it through a telescope. And this is a star that's close to my heart, and I will share with you why that is. So if we were to point out some of the other things besides Deneb, the tail of the swan, that's estimated to be 2600 light years away. And then here we have Albireo, represented by the head of the swan, and it's estimated to be 380 light years. There are some other constellations and stars worth pointing out here. So here we have Lyra, that is represented as a harp in Western astronomy, and then we have Vega, which is the brightest star in the constellation of Lyra. And here we have Altair and Aquila. Altair is the star, Aquila is the constellation. If you want to learn more about these two subjects, go see that video. And from here, we are going to focus on Albireo, because Albireo is the star that represents the head or bill of the swan. So upon first look, it seems like any average star, but when you magnify it with a telescope, it's revealed to be a beautiful double star. One star is orangish-gold in color, while the other is bright blue. And I have a few different pictures to share with you. Before, it was thought to be a binary system, but the current research points to it being an optical double. So they're not really in a star system together, it's just an optical illusion. They look like they're right next to each other. If we were to zoom in, here's another great shot of Albireo. And here is an amazing shot. And the reason I wanted to share this star system with you is because it is the name of one of my pets. This is Albireo, and he is what I call him, my forever kitten, because he is 2 years old now, and I had him as a foster kitten, but it was a foster fail, and I ended up falling in love with him. And we couldn't come up with a name for him, so we didn't name him for a few days, and then I came up with Albireo because he's got that one blue eye and one golden eye. Now, trying to explain this briefly to other people, it doesn't always make sense, but I get the opportunity to explain it and share it with you. So this is Albireo, my little kitten, and when I look at these two stars in the sky, this is often what I see. Now let's focus on some of the characteristics of Albireo and what you would see if you were to look at it through a telescope. So here we have a picture of Albireo, the star system right here. It's taken with an 8-inch telescope, so it's definitely possible to see two different colors right here when you're looking at it. However, if you're looking at Albireo with the unaided eye, you're not going to see two points of different colors of light. So if we were to zoom in here, it's not actually just a binary system, it's actually a triple system, because Albireo A has two stars. I'm gonna guess here that maybe this is the other second star right there. This is an orange type star, and then the other smaller one in the system that you wouldn't really be able to see through a telescope is a smaller blue type star. And then Albireo B, which is this other blue point of light you're looking at here, this is classified as an A star. Its spectral class is A, which means that it is blue. So remember, if you want to see the two different points of light, be sure to use a telescope when looking at this. I remember the first time I saw this in a telescope, I was really surprised that I was able to point out the colors. Sometimes color in the sky at night is really difficult to determine, but when you look at this one, it has a very distinct gold and blue hue. In terms of distance, I found a range of values. It's estimated that this system could be between 300 or up to 415 light years away. There's just a range because it depends upon the type of instrument we're using to look at it. And as our technology gets better over the years, we will get better values in terms of distances with stars. But it's estimated to be in this particular range. Now that you know more about the star known as Albireo, let's get a little bit more practice with how to identify it in the sky. So here is a great broad view of the summer sky. You've got the Milky Way on one side, and then over here, hopefully you can point out the summer triangle asterism. And from there, you want to find Vega, which is the brightest star in the summer triangle. Here is Deneb. This is the tail of the swan. I look for the cross-shaped pattern in the sky. And then I go to the top of the swan, the head of the swan, and that is Albireo. So it's not quite in the center of the summer triangle, but it's nearby. So use that as another way to gauge where Albireo is in the sky. Let's take a look at one more picture to get some more practice. Here we have another star picture that has a lot going on. I can clearly see Scorpius right here. This is the heart of the Milky Way because it's the brightest. We have Sagittarius down here, Corona Australis, Ophiuchus is all up in here. But then we look for the summer triangle right there. So from the summer triangle, can you point out where Cygnus is? Find the tail of the swan and then find that cross-like pattern right here and here. And that is where Albireo is. And if we were to point everything out, here it is, this glorious photo. I just love it because there's so much here, and it's a great picture to kind of toggle back and forth to get some practice just identifying where everything is. And I didn't quite label everything. Hercules is up in this area as well, but Cygnus is here, and then Albireo is right towards the center of the summer asterism, or summer triangle asterism. So I hope this was helpful. I hope you enjoyed learning more about Albireo, this super cool system. I hope you get a chance to look at it through a telescope. It really is a fascinating star to see. Good luck. I wish you clear skies and keep looking up.